One of the huge upsides of social media is access to information and the ability for fraudulent activities to get exposed. What's happened recently on Reddit is beautiful to see. Wall Street Bets subreddit has now reached 5.1 million members as of the making of this video, and it's going global. Let's pretend the house down the street from you is worth $100,000. Imagine being able to borrow $140,000, go on TV, and let everyone know that the neighborhood home values are tanking and everyone should sell, sell, sell. And then you profit when the house values drop. That's market manipulation, right? I think what we're seeing now with the GME saga is a byproduct of wealth inequality. This is a perfect storm of millions of Americans losing their jobs, small businesses getting shut down, and constantly seeing the ultra wealthy exponentially grow their wealth. Homeownership is becoming increasingly more difficult. The gap between the top 1% and the bottom 99% is growing, and people are becoming more aware of corruption by our political leaders. And now we're seeing complete corruption of the stock market right in front of our eyes. Once Wall Street Bets found their own loophole, they exploited it just like any rational investor would. Hedge fund managers, I'm sure, love promoting free market capitalism, but only when it works in their favor. We have to make sure all of the top dogs at the table in this game can afford an extra yacht this year because 2020 was tough on everyone. That new 5,000 square foot house in the mansions doesn't pay for itself, know what I mean?
The reason the market is doing what it's doing is people are sitting at home getting the checks from the government, okay? And this fair share is a bullshit concept. It's just a way of attacking wealthy people. And, you know, I think it's inappropriate. We all got to work together and pull together.
Greed really works for the wealthy because that character trait gets you to the top. And when your greedy behavior backfires, you just phone up your friends over at Citadel and make sure you don't lose your shirt. See, when small retail investors take on risk, they have to eat the losses if their risky investment doesn't pay off. But when you have a seat at the table of corrupt policymakers, you can just use the phone a friend feature from Who Wants to Be a Millionaire.
I like to call my parents right now.
Sure.
Use my lifeline, call my parents.
Robinhood positioned itself as the good guys, the app that gave access to the small investors so that they can compete at the same table as the big guys. No more fees, no more brokers. Sign up with us and we'll even give you a free stock. Don't tell anyone that we're going to use your data to hand over to the big hedge funds to use against you, though. As long as the customers don't read that in the fine print terms and conditions, Robinhood will be safe. Here's a tweet from 2016 that aged like milk. Tyler Winklevoss sums it up well here. Bully capital has been pile-driving stonks for years, creating more short interest than float. Wall Street never complained. Now that Wall Street Bets has turned the tables and given the suits a taste of their own medicine, the suits are crying bloody murder. Citadel is an investor in Melvin Capital, which got run over by Wall Street Bets. Citadel is also Robinhood's biggest customer. Robinhood was never what it pretended to be. It built its business on selling Wall Street Bets order flow to the hedge fund Citadel. In the moment of truth, we learned which customer it cares about the most. This is going much deeper than a meme stock on a subreddit. Wall Street Bets has basically exploited the system just like the wealthy were exploiting these small guys for so long. The corruption is out in the open now. We all see it. Here's a great tweet from Dave Portnoy. And it turns out Robinhood app is the biggest frauds of them all, democratizing finance for all, except when we manipulate the market because too many ordinary people are getting rich. Back to Robinhood. They're just another company who put out a front that they're for the little guy while doing the exact opposite. There's probably decisions that happen that we can't see. It's possible that stronger powers are controlling Robinhood and they're the poor guy getting beat up without a fight, but they're also a symbol for the corrupt system that we all play in. And they're complicit in the entire scheme. In light of current market volatility, we are restricting transactions for certain securities to position closing only, including AMC and GME. But they also post tweets like this, leading us to believe that they're in bed with the powers that be. If they decide to go public with an IPO, it would be fascinating to see where their income streams come from. It's likely that we'll never know 100% for sure, but you can be certain that there are deals behind the scenes that allow Robinhood to send data to the power players to use against you. For years, the power players can go on the news, being watched by millions, and subtly promote their positions. I think GME is going to zero. I think the stock market is headed for a bubble and a crash. Billionaire Spencer Cornelio, you need to listen to him. They're attempting to manipulate unsophisticated investors, and everyone knew this. But once a group of 2 million yahoos got together and decide they like a stock, it's market manipulation and we need to halt trading? Are you kidding me? This is almost poetic. The wealthy are trying to pull out every single advantage they have. They're unloading their full barrel. Manipulate the news by saying they've closed their positions? Check. Shut down Discord servers? Check. Bail out a company by sending over $2.75 billion to save them? Check. Shut down trading? Check. What's next? Wall Street Bets isn't doing anything illegal. They saw greed in the form of hedge funds borrowing more stock than existed and trying to get the stock to tank to zero. Capitalism allows for free market trading, right? But only if the wealthy are winning. They want to implement rules when they start losing. When their greed turns on them, all of a sudden bailouts and halting trading needs to happen. There's also belief that the hedge funds were still able to trade the stock while retail investors were shut out. How is this fair? Oh yeah, that's right, it isn't. We play by different rules than they do. This Wall Street Journal article titled "Robinhood Faces SEC Probe for Not Disclosing Deals with High-Speed Traders" details that the company could have to pay a fine exceeding $10 million if it agrees to settle. I feel like this is just a very light slap on the wrist. $10 million? If they go public, this is a rounding error on their balance sheet. $10 million? That's like sending a trust fund baby to time out in his 3,000 square foot guest house replete with hookers, blow, and ping pong tables. A system is healthy when everyone can win and lose equally. If I take huge risks by YOLOing into an investment class like equities or flipping houses, then I should lose money if I fail. If billionaires take huge risks and lose all of their capital, then they should have to start over like any of us. But then, that would mean they'd have to focus on pulling themselves up by their bootstraps. Robinhood is now down to a 1-star review in the Google Play Store. What's funny is I checked the app a few hours ago and there were significantly more reviews than there are now. They must be deleting the criticism faster than Nikola was trying to do. I imagine the C-suite executives were calling every PR firm in LA trying to find someone to save them from a burning building. Please, can you bail us out of the mess we made? Our shady business practices led us to a risky position and our customers found out and now we need to be bailed out. Please, please, please. Robinhood attacked the market aggressively and allowed small retail investors to play ball. They invested in promoting their app by teaming up with a lot of awesome YouTube creators and it led to a lot of people starting their investing career. But sadly, the company who wanted to be known as the app giving the little guy a chance, we all just found out that they were in bed with the bully all along. I hope GME goes to the moon and bankrupts some of these billion-dollar hedge funds. When you take risks and lose, like borrowing more shares than exist, you're supposed to lose it all when it goes sideways. This will be a story that we'll remember for many years to come, as regulation will certainly be next to make sure this doesn't happen again. We gotta protect the ultra-wealthy from losing money. Yachts aren't cheap anymore, you know? Thank you so much for watching.